magnetic field due to straight finite current carrying conductor. So I'll be taking one straight current carrying conductor. I'm considering this as straight current carrying conductor. This is finite. And in this, I consider it as some current I flowing over here. And this is the center. I want to now calculate magnetic field at this position. At this point, I want to find out magnetic field. And this point, I consider it as P. And for this, I am taking very small element over here. And that element is at this position. That element is here. And it is in upward direction. This is the element which I am choosing. Okay. This element I am considering. This element is in upward. Now, from here to here, we need to calculate the distance. And this is the direction of current. This is direction of the current. This angle is theta according to dB. And let me take this as capital R. And let me take it as L. This become under root L square plus R square. Okay. I want to now find out magnetic field over here. So when we are dealing with magnetic field, this is a DL bar and this is R bar. I need to resolve this DL bar into components. So I'll resolve that DL bar into component. One component in this direction and another component in this direction. Okay, and this is DL. This angle I consider it as some phi. DL into cos phi, and this is DL into sin phi. And because of this DL cos phi, DL cos phi is exactly making an angle 90 degrees. Because of this DL cos phi, magnetic field will be produced in this direction exactly perpendicular to that. This is a dB, right? I can now resolve dB into two components. This angle and this angle are identical. This I am considering it as phi. This I am considering it as phi. I can resolve this dB into components. One component in this direction, another component in this direction. So this is dB into cos phi, and this is dB into sin. Like this, because of one small element over here, you will be getting one more magnetic field in this direction, that is dB cos phi, and this is dB sin phi. So overall, I can now write magnetic field dB integration dB into sin phi. But what is a dB? dB is equal to mu naught I divided by 4 pi into DL divided by R square, which is mu naught I divided by DL. Already we have took here 90 degrees with respect to this DL cos pi. It is making 90 degrees. Corresponding to that, we have took dB. So again, you need not take sine theta here. DL divided by 4 pi into, this is the distance R, which is L square plus R square. Under root and whole square gets cancelled. Right? I'll substitute that here. B is equal to integration mu naught I into DL divided by 4 pi into L square plus R square into sin. Okay. Let me take this as equation number 1. Now I am considering this triangle. Let me take this triangle as O PQ. from triangle OPQ, you can write tan pi is equal to, tan pi is equal to L divided by R. I can write L is equal to R into tan pi. DL is equal to R into tan pi. I can write it as secant square pi d pi. I'll just substitute these values here. That gives you magnetic field dB. So it is B equal to constant terms, you bring it out, mu naught I divided by 4 pi constant, I am bringing it out, integration sine pi into, what is a DL? DL is R secant square pi d pi divided by L square. L square is R square tan square pi plus R square, I am taking it common. So it is tan square pi plus 1. What is tan square pi plus 1? It is secant square pi. Secant square pi gets cancelled. And this R gets cancelled. B will be equal to mu naught I divided by 4 pi capital R integration sine pi into d pi. Okay. Now, this is mu naught I divided by 4 pi R into sine pi d pi. And integration limits, you need to take it as this theta value. This is theta, right? Now, if I consider this total element from here to here and from here to here, this bottom angle, I'm considering it as pi 1 and this is minus. And this top angle, I am considering it as plus pi 2. Okay. I can now substitute that over there. If I substitute that over here, within the limits, minus pi 1, 2 plus pi 1. And if you integrate this, you will be getting equation for net magnetic field. Right. And if you integrate this and after substituting the proper limits value, you will be getting magnetic field mu naught I divided by 4 pi capital R into sine pi 1 plus sine pi 2. This is the final expression for magnetic field due to straight current carrying conductor. Yeah. Students, we have got equation for this magnetic field due to straight current carrying conductor. I'll now tell you how to use this formula. This is exactly at the center and this is current carrying conductor I. Now, I want to find out magnetic field at this position. Okay, this point. This total angle which we are considering, it is, this is pi 1 and minus this is pi 2. Okay, if it is exactly at the center, then both angles will be same. If both angles are same, that means above it is pi and below also it is pi, then we will be substituting that values here. But in this case, we have angles pi 1 and pi 2. If this is length L2 and this is length L1. Okay, suppose if we are considering this as the angles. This is theta 2, this is theta 1, okay? How do you write this relation between theta 2 and pi 2? Theta 2 plus pi 2 is equal to 90 degrees and theta 1 plus pi 1 is equal to 90 degrees. I can use this relation over here. B is equal to mu naught I divided by 4 pi capital R into sine of, what is pi 1? Pi 1 can be written as 90 minus theta 1 plus sine of 90 minus theta. This is equal to mu naught I divided by 4 pi capital R into cos of theta 1 plus cos of theta 2. This is one more equation which you can use to find out magnetic field due to straight current carrying conductor. And remember, both the formulas you can use. You can use either this formula. You can use either this formula or you can use either this formula. But remember, so when we are dealing with the first one, the angles are made with the horizontal. In this case, pi 1 and pi 2 angles are with horizontal. But whereas if you are taking cos 1, cos theta 1 and cos theta 2, these are theta 1 and theta 2 are angles made with wire. If we are considering the angle, sometimes in problems they will be giving you angle with horizontal, sometimes they will be giving you angles with wire. Based on that, you need to select the formula. So when the angles are given with respect to wire, if you are taking sine pi 1 and sine pi 2, then you will get wrong answer. So choose properly which angles are being given. Now I'll take anyone, like if I am considering this is extended up to infinity. If these are extended up to infinity, for infinite straight wire, if it is infinite straight wire, what happens to these angles? Pi 1 will become 90 degrees. Pi 2 also become 90 degrees, theta 1 will become 0 degrees, theta 2 will become 0 degrees because it is extended up to infinity, right? So as it is in extended up to infinity, what happens to this angle? It goes on, finally it will become 90 degrees, which I am showing it in the video. So wire length increases. If it is finite wire, wire length it increases, so slowly angle is this much. And if the wire is extended up to infinity, then in such cases, the angle will be going on increased. Because if it is infinity, theta, pi 1 and pi 2 angles will be up to 90 degrees. So therefore, pi 1, pi 2 as they are 90, you can just write here, magnetic field B is equal to mu naught I divided by 4 pi capital R into sine 90. It is 1 plus 1, which is equal to mu naught I divided by 4 pi capital R into 2. This and this gets cancelled. B is equal to mu naught I divided by 2 pi R. This is equation for magnetic field due to infinite straight current carrying conductor. So it is infinite straight current carrying conductor. Okay. So like this, we can select the angles and we can find out magnetic field due to finite straight current carrying conductor and infinite straight current carrying conductor. Now this is case one where you have current carrying conductor in which current I is passing through. I want to find out magnetic field here at the bottom of wire. Above it is extended up to infinity. At the bottom of the wire you want to find out magnetic field at this position. So therefore pi 1 will be equal to 0. Pi 2 will become 90 degrees. So therefore magnetic field B will be equal to mu naught I divided by 4 pi capital R into sine 0 plus sine 90. This is B equal to mu naught I divided by 4 pi R. And this magnetic field is in which direction? So you need to just find out the direction by using right hand thumb rule. And these fingers, the four fingers are represented into towards the screen. Therefore, magnetic field here, you should represent it with into. That is P. Next, let me take case 2. Case 2, where you are taking a current carrying conductor and it is extended up to infinity in downward direction, and you are calculating magnetic field at this point. B is equal to how much? Now, this angle is theta. This is pi 1, which is equal to 90 degrees. And above angle is pi 2. Pi 2 is equal to 0 degrees. Okay. So, pi 1 is 90. Pi 2 is equal to 0. I'll just use that formula here. B equal to mu naught I divided by 4 pi capital R into sine 90 plus 0. Therefore, B will be equal to mu naught I divided by 4 pi R, and the magnetic field will be out. Check it up. This side it will be into, and this side it is out. Therefore, magnetic field here is outward. That is case 2. Okay. And case 3, it can be like this. So these are two infinite wires where you are finding magnetic field at the bottom or at the top of the infinite wires. If both sides are extended up to infinity, just like how I have told you, if this is extended up to infinity and this is extended up to infinity, magnetic field here B is equal to mu naught I divided by 4 pi capital R into sine 90 plus sine 90. This is magnetic field. If the current is going in upward direction, magnetic field here will be into, magnetic field here will be out. So therefore, magnetic field this side will be mu naught I divided by 2 pi capital R, where capital R is the separation where you are finding magnetic field. That is case 3. Likewise, you can take case 4, where this is one wire and this is one wire, and I want to find out magnetic field at this position. This distance is capital R. This distance is capital R. Current is going in this direction, and this is extended up to infinity. This is extended up to infinity. So I want to find out magnetic field at this position. So in order to find out magnetic field at this point, because of this two wires, magnetic field will be developed. This is segment 1. And this is segment 2. So because of this first segment, magnetic field is produced at this much. Like this is R, obviously. This becomes 45 degrees. And this side it will be 90 degrees. So magnetic field due to segment 1 will be equal to mu naught I divided by 4 pi capital R into sine 45 plus sine 90 will be equal to 1. And what about its direction? Direction will be into, check it up, current going in upward direction. These four fingers, it is into. Therefore, B1 is into. Next, B2 is equal to, this angle will also be equal to 45 degrees. And other angle will be 90. It is mu naught I divided by 4 pi capital R into sine 90. Okay, sine 45 plus sine 90. Sine 90 will be equal to 1. And what about magnetic field? Magnetic field here, this is current carrying conductor. And my four fingers above the wire is coming outward. So this side it is out. And this side it is into. And this also will be into. So net magnetic field B bar will be equal to B1 plus B2. So what is net magnetic field B1 plus B2? So B1 plus B2 will be equal to mu naught I divided by 4 pi capital R into 1 plus 1 by root 2. And this is 2 times, so it is 2. This is net magnetic field. And this magnetic field is into the plane of the screen. This is the way you can use magnetic field due to straight finite wire formula, and we can apply it for different cases of the wire. Yeah, students, we have a finite square loop here. I want to find out magnetic field produced at this center. So in order to find out magnetic field produced at this center, let me consider each side as A. Okay. I name this as A, B, C, and D. Magnetic field B net will be equal to magnetic field produced due to AB plus magnetic field produced due to BC plus magnetic field produced due to CD plus magnetic field produced due to DA. As a separation, RAB is equal to RBC is equal to RCA is equal to RAD is equal to A by 2. All the distances are same. This is half of the length, A by 2. And this is half of the length, A by 2. This is half of the length, A by 2. This is half of the length, A by 2. All distances are same. And what about the angles? When we are calculating the angles, check it up. This is the angle pi 1 and this is the angle pi 2. One is angle pi 1 and the other one is pi 2. This is pi 1 and this is pi 2. Okay. What about pi 1 here? Pi 1 will be this angle. This is A by 2. This is also A by 2. So therefore it is 45 degrees. And pi 2 is also equal to 45 degrees. Okay. So what about the directions? Magnetic field BAB. Because of AB, magnetic field is into. Check it out. AB, because of this AB, magnetic field here will be out. Magnetic field here will be into. Next, above that BC, magnetic field is out. Here it is out. And here it is into. And because of this, here it is out. And here it is into. Next, because of this, here it is out. And here it is into. So all magnetic fields are into the plane. So therefore, B net will be equal to 4 times B AB. Because all the magnitudes are same. The magnitude of BAB is equal to magnitude of BBC is equal to magnitude of BCA is equal to magnitude of BAD. Therefore, B net can be written as mu naught I divided by 4 pi, distance is A by 2, into sine pi 1, that is 45 degrees, plus sine pi 2, that is 45 degrees. This is 4 times. 4 gets cancelled and it is into. Mu naught I, this 2 goes to numerator, divided by pi A into sine 45 is 1 by root 2 plus 1 by root 2. This is into. And this can be written as 2 mu naught I divided by pi A into 2 by root 2, that is root 2. This is equal to mu naught I divided by pi A 2 root 2 and it is into. This is net magnetic field due to this square root.